situation was evolving, that the Cabinet Crisis Committee of the New South Wales Government would take the advice, the health advice that was provided to us later that morning or this morning. And I will say this, that the New South Wales Government has always prided itself on taking the expert health advice. We're never afraid to take a decision. We need to keep our citizens safe. And even though we don't want to impose burdens unless we absolutely have to, unfortunately, this is a situation where we absolutely have to. A few days ago, I said this was the scariest time that I felt since the pandemic started, and that's proven to be the case. So from 6 p.m. today, all of Greater Sydney, the Blue Mountains, the Central Coast and Wollongong will go into a lockdown with stay-at-home orders in place until midnight Friday the 9th of July. So essentially, a fortnight from midnight yesterday, all of Greater Sydney, the Blue Mountains, Central Coast and Wollongong will go into lockdown with stay-at-home provisions. What does that mean? It means all of us have to stay home unless for the four following reasons. Unless we have to work outside the home or get educated outside the home, and given school holidays, that obviously doesn't apply. But if you must work outside the home, you're able to do that. If you need to seek medical attention, including getting a COVID test, getting a vaccine or any other medical attention, you're allowed to. And you're also allowed to leave the home for care and compassionate grounds as well. And obviously, you're allowed outside to purchase goods, essential goods and services. And I know I'll say this, and I please appreciate people following these instructions. There is no need to panic buy. All the shops will be open every day of the week. There is no curfew. You can leave your home at any stage to purchase any essential goods that you need to. And that is a given. So please be thoughtful and considerate about fellow citizens, and no need to panic buy. For the next 2 weeks, you will be able to exercise outdoors, and we appreciate during the school holidays, this could be the only time that people are able to gather outside and in no more than groups of 10. So in the regions that we've outlined, in no more than groups of 10, you're able to gather outside for that recreational exercise. And of course, when you are outdoors in groups of 10, make sure you maintain a good social distance and follow the health instructions. Weddings are able to proceed tomorrow. Obviously, today and tomorrow, it's both lacks compassion and also not fair to cancel weddings. So today and tomorrow, COVID-safe weddings will be able to take place. But unfortunately, from Monday, for the duration of the lockdown, weddings can't take place. Funerals can take place with a maximum of 100, one per square 4 metre, masks indoors. Can I also stress that during this time, even when you're going out to buy food or going about your business or essential work, that every time you enter a business or any premise that you use the QR codes. As you know, the New South Wales government is mandating for QR codes to be everywhere at all times. So make sure, no matter whether it's a temporary purchase, if you're going into a supermarket or you're going to grab a takeaway, that you do log into your QR codes, and that's really important. I also want to foreshadow that nobody should feel stressed about their financial situation. Obviously, there are provisions for us, and we will, as a state government, in the next few days, we'll be announcing support to businesses, and also the federal government support to household kicks in at a certain time, and obviously that will kick in. So nobody should feel stressed or pressure to break any of the rules because of their financial situation. The New South Wales government will be there to support businesses, and of course the Commonwealth support to households kicks in as well, and we will provide that information and that detail in the next few days. But in the meantime, I don't want anyone to feel stressed more than we need to, and I don't want anyone to feel panicked about their financial situation. Now, what happens in the rest of New South Wales? Well, regional New South Wales, so the areas that I haven't spoken about, which aren't in lockdown, will have to undergo restrictions that have been in place for broader Sydney. So in the regions, no more than 5 visitors in your home. All hospitality has to be seated, 1 per 4 square metre rule. Only a 50% capacity for outdoor events, indoor mask wearing, and again, restrictions in relation to funerals and weddings. So for those parts of New South Wales that aren't in lockdown, restrictions still apply, because we want to make sure that if there have been any occasions where people unknowingly have taken the virus outside into the regions, that we don't have any spread in those regions. Now, Dr. Chan has often said that when you have a contagious variant like the Delta virus, a three-day lockdown doesn't work. If we're going to do this, we need to do it properly. There's no point doing a three-day lockdown and then having the virus continue to bubble away in the community. Now, if after 7 days there's a dramatic change in the trend, well, obviously we'll evaluate the situation. But at this stage, the best health advice we have is that a two-week period, or until midnight the Friday the 9th of July, is necessary in order to make sure we get to our target of zero community transmission, which has always been our target from the beginning of the pandemic. Given how transmissible the virus is, given the extra exposure venues, we know that even the best contact tracers in the world can't stay a step ahead unless we put this in, and we need to do it properly. So there was no point doing it for 3 days or 5 days because it wouldn't have done the job. The best health advice today is that it should be for 2 weeks, but if there is any massive improvement ahead of that time, of course we'll evaluate that. But the best advice we have from Dr. Chan and the health experts is that we should brace ourselves for more cases. We're finding that all household contacts, unfortunately, are getting the virus. Transmissibility is at least double what previous variants have been. So we do need to brace ourselves for potentially larger number of cases in the following days. And that's why it's so important we take action now. We always take the best advice, best health advice in New South Wales. And this is the best advice we have. And I please know that we'll get through this. It's never easy when all of us have to face these circumstances, but we're all in the same situation. We've had to do this before. We know the drill. And I'm just asking everybody not to cut corners, because if just a handful of people cut corners, all of us end up in a very difficult situation. I just want to thank everybody for your patience. I want to thank you for trusting the government. We trust our people. We trust our people to do the right thing. And we hope that at the end of the 14-day period or 13 or July the 9th, we all look back and can feel proud of the way in which we all came together and responded. I'll now ask Dr. Chan to reinforce the messages she wants all of us to hear as our Chief Medical Officer. And I do want to thank her and the team. Our contact tracers have been amazing. But when you uncover just one case that's been to a number of venues for a couple of days, that is a huge risk under these circumstances, and that's why we're taking the action we are. And after Dr. Chan reinforces the messages, Minister Hazzard will say a few words. And obviously, I'll just make this point as well. If you are from regional New South Wales currently in those areas that are being locked down, you have to sensibly make way back to your homes, but you have to keep yourself isolated for 14 days. And I'll ask Dr. Chan to repeat that message to make sure that if anybody unintentionally has the virus and goes back home, that they self-isolate for 14 days to make sure that it doesn't get out into the community. And after Dr. Chan gives her update, Minister Hazzard will say a few words and then we'll take a few questions. Thank you.
Thank you, Premier. So the key message is we do not want to see, we need these measures in place. We need these measures in place to allow us to bring this outbreak under control. As the Premier has indicated, the contact tracing and testing numbers, despite them being quite high, the testing numbers, and the contact tracers getting in contact with people rapidly, what we're seeing is by the time we've got there and uncovered these chains of transmission, we have had a number of people infectious in the community. Given we are aiming to get to no community transmission, and as we roll out the vaccine, it is important that we get to that as quickly as possible. So the restrictions need to be applied absolutely, and it's critical that we all comply with them if we are going to achieve that no community transmission, and the duration of the lockdown remains at that 14, around that 14 days. Also, it is important that we do not seed our regional communities. So anyone who has been in Sydney, Greater Sydney, from the 21st of June, we're asking you to stay at home for 14 days since you've left that area. And the reason for that is we want to make sure that you minimise your transmission risk to anyone else. As we are now uncovering, it might be that you're out in the regions, but you haven't been aware yet. that there was an infectious person there. So this is a prudent precaution to stop those regional seeding events. Also, you are permitted to go to work and leave the Greater Metropolitan Sydney for work and essential reasons, as the Premier has indicated. Please do not risk it and say, oh, I'm going to go, I really have an essential reason, or my work is essential. Please consider that. We want to maintain essential workers to going into those areas, but they will be subject to the stay-at-home provisions when they get there. And please don't try and shortcut or in any way sidestep the rules. As the Premier has said, if we all work together, we will have the greatest confidence in bringing this outbreak to its conclusion as rapidly as we possibly can.
I just want to emphasise that the concerns we have at the moment are extremely high. The Delta variant of this virus is certainly moving around our community far faster than anyone could have imagined, and it's now up to all of us to fight back. We can fight back by taking simple measures. Just following the instructions that our Chief Health Officer have given is potentially the answer. I want to also emphasise that the point that we don't want this virus, this very dangerous virus, to get into our regional communities. We know it's already circulating here in parts of Sydney. We don't want it into the regional areas. As you'd be aware, there was some fragments found in the Bourke sewage system. We are concerned that people may have travelled out into the regions. If you are out there in the regions, Chief Health Officer has said, from the 21st of June onwards, stop wherever you are and isolate for the 14 days since that period, since you left Sydney. I also want to stress to the employers in New South Wales, there is now going to be a health order, there is a health order, which actually sets out that your employees, if possible, should be working from home. That's a clear requirement to stop the movement around our community. So again, I apologise to the business sector, but I think we found that we can be extremely productive with our workers working at home. And certainly to allow them to do that will minimise at least one group of people from moving around unnecessarily. Finally, I just want to say this. The emphasis now is to defeat this virus. We all need to stop moving around unless we absolutely have to. Don't play games with yourself and with the community. Please stay at home unless you really need to go out or you have one of those four reasons. And even then, think twice before you do it. Thank you.